Alright, a very very good evening to all of you. Hello everyone, I am Dr. Tushar Mehta. I'm an orthopedic surgeon and the faculty of orthopedics at DAMS. Today this small session is kind of a demo session where I will be discussing one very important clinical topic with you. We'll try to make concepts out of that topic. We will try to understand that topic. And not only we will solve MCQs, but we will try to have a proper clinical pathological as well as clinical radiological correlation of that topic. This topic that I have chosen, this is something that you all encounter in your day-to-day practice, in your daily life, in your homes as well. You have parents, you have grandparents. And you know, most of them, they come to you and tell you and probably ask you ki doctor to ban gaya hai mere ghutne ka dard kab dur karega. So in English I'll translate that, you know, you have become a doctor or you're in the process of becoming a doctor, but when are you going to treat my pain in my knees? So we'll talk about that. So first of all, the topic is osteoarthritis, you know, ghar ghar ki problem. Everywhere you see this, wherever you have elderly people at home. Now when we talk about this term osteoarthritis, you have to understand osteo means bone, arth means joint, itis means inflammation. So it is an inflammatory disorder of osteo and arth, that means bone and joints. But I want you to understand, but I want you to understand that, you know, it is not exactly a pure inflammation. I do agree inflammation happens, but it is not a pure inflammatory disorder. It is more of a degenerative disorder. Are you able to understand my point of view here? It is more of a degenerative disorder, and that is why majority of the people, they want to call this condition as degenerative joint disease, and osteoarthritis is now allegedly, you know, it's a misnomer, because it is not a primarily inflammatory joint pathology. It is more of a degenerative joint pathology. So some people call it DJD. In fact, there is one more name given to it. That is what is called as osteoarthrosis. I'm sure you understand. Osis means effusion. So joint gets effusion. I mean, there is a lot of swelling inside the joint because of the fluid accumulation. I would summarize it in just one word, that it is wear and tear joint disease. Main isko, I know I'm very fond of this word, simple, as simple as that, that it is wear and tear joint disease. It is nothing but, you know, with aging, with senility, with senescence, you know, baal safed ho jate hain. So it is a part of wear and tear, nothing much fancy about it. Now the common joints which are involved, we have to talk about them. So the common joints which are involved is certainly the most common joint. I mean, there is no confusion about it, that the most common joint which is involved is knee. So there's no doubt about it. After knee, yes, hip is a common joint. In fact, spine is a common joint. So I would say knee is a common joint, hip is a common joint, spine is a common joint. Do you see any similarity between these three joints? All the three are large weight bearing joints. All the three are large weight bearing joints. So primarily it affects the large weight bearing joints, but that doesn't mean that it does not happen in small joints. It does happen in small joints also. PIP is a small joint, DIP is a small joint, first carpometacarpal is a small joint, first metatarsophalangeal is a small joint. So PIP hai, DIP hai, first carpometacarpal hai, first MTP. These are the four important small joints which are involved. Okay, and these are the four important small joints which are involved. In large joint, I have already told you knee, hip and spine. Now there is a point that I want you to understand here, that there are two joints which are never ever 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 involved. There are two joints which are never involved. One is the metacarpophalangeal joint and second one is the wrist. So always remember this, that this joint, metacarpophalangeal joint and the wrist joint, metacarpophalangeal joint and wrist joint, they are never ever involved in osteoarthritis. It could be involved in osteoarthritis because they are classically involved in because they are classically involved in rheumatoid arthritis. Right? So they are classically involved in rheumatoid arthritis. So it is sparing, osteoarthritis is sparing of these two joints because they are classically involved there. Now, which is the primary layer which is involved in the pathogenesis? I want all of you to understand. The primary layer involved in the pathogenesis is what is called as articular cartilage. I do hope that you all understand what articular cartilage is. When I talk about articular cartilage, how articular cartilage is involved, there is a staging which is given in explaining the pathogenesis of osteoarthritis called as outer bridge staging. It has got four stages for sure, and don't worry, we will discuss those four stages one by one. I hope you understand, sometimes what happens that, there's an old construction, a Purani construction, there's an old construction house. Initially, you observe that, the walls, they have become damp. The water content increases, the water seeps in. So something like this happens in stage one, that water content of the articular cartilage increases, leading to what? Softening of the cartilage, leading to what? Edema of the cartilage, leading to what? Effusion of the cartilage. Now I'm sure you guys will agree with me. What happens, after that softening, after that edema of that wall, of that paint of the wall, couple of days later you see small cracks, fissures, fragments. So basically cracks appears, fissures appear, the articular cartilage starts getting fragmentation. Another couple of days later you see, the green color paint has been slightly chipped off. So something like this happens here also, that there is a partial detachment of the articular cartilage. Okay, now another couple of days later you see that the complete green, orange, whatever paint was there has been chipped off, and you can see the bare wall, you can see the bare bricks. So what is stage 4 is? Stage 4 is complete detachment. Stage 4 is complete detachment of articular cartilage. Now this will lead to what? This will lead to denuded bone, this will lead to exposed bone, this will lead to bare bone. So you have a bare femoral condyle, you have a bare tibial condyle. Now these two bare bones will start rubbing against each other. So I hope you understand the pathogenesis of the topic here. Right now, after this pathogenesis, the next thing that I want you to understand is the classical clinical picture. Many of you would have seen this. If you're not, don't worry, today I'll show it to you. Typical Indian scenario: a 60 plus female entering into your OPD. The first symptom of this disease was, is, and will always remain what? Pain. You are a doctor, you have certain duties, your duty is, somebody tells you pain, you try to touch that area. What a patient says is a symptom, what you see is a sign. The moment you examine that, you see, oh, tenderness. You press that area, the lady cries, it is tender. The next thing that you see, the knee is swollen. Next thing she tells you, doctor, whenever I sit down from a standing posture or when I stand from a sitting posture, I can hear that cut. Why do you hear that? Because you have exposed bones, so they rub against each other, that leads to what? Crepitus. The next line, doctor, I was able to, walk up to the adjacent temple till last week. Today I cannot even go up to the kitchen to make my own chapatis. I cannot even go to the loo. So decreased walking distance. Then, after pain, tenderness, swelling, crepitus, decreased walking distance, you talk about what? MCQ. Because at the end of the day, the purpose is to solve MCQ. So you start looking for typical deformities of osteoarthritis. The first deformity that you want to see is what is called as Bowcard nodes. The third deformity that you would want to see is called as Herberton nodes. The second deformity is Herberton node. The third deformity that you would want to see is what is called as genovarus. Now, first of all, Bowcard nodes. Bowcard node. I do hope that this visual presentation gives you a clear-cut explanation of what is a Bowcard node. So, symmetrical enlargement of the PIP is what is called as Bowcard node. Symmetrical enlargement of the DIP is what is called as Herberton node. Okay, and the third deformity that you see here is what is called as genuvarum. I'm sure you can very well appreciate that the part distal to genu, that is the leg, the tibia and fibula, if they are going towards the midline, that is what is called as genuvarum. So this is the point I was trying to convey here, that you see involvement of proximal interphalangeal joint, Bowcard node, you see involvement of distal interphalangeal joint, Herberton node, and osteoarthritis is certainly the most common cause of genuvarus in elderly. Please remember this MCQ also. This is the most common cause of genuvarus in elderly population. Alright, so after understanding the concept of the disease, the etiology, the pathogenesis, the staging, the clinical picture, now we can come to the conclusion, that is diagnosis and treatment. So first of all, diagnosis. Now in diagnosis, theek hai, now beta, you have to understand na, because you have grandparents at home. So whosoever is presenting to you with the same clinical picture that I've explained, whenever you talk about diagnosis, MRI has got no sense at all. There's no need for MRI, shMRI and all. The only thing which is required is X-ray, and in that X-ray, both knees is required. One view which is required is AP standing view. Another view which is required is a lateral. Now, when you ask for this X-ray, of course, you are going to see certain X-ray signs. And in these X-ray signs, always remember that the first X-ray sign that you are going to see, yes, can anybody tell me what is the first X-ray sign? It is the reduction of the joint space. The first X-ray sign is the reduction of the joint space. Now, you have to understand a beautiful thing. What kind of a reduction is this? Symmetric or asymmetric? This is a classical asymmetric reduction of the joint space, because I want you to understand that medial reduction is more than the lateral reduction. Medial narrowing is more than lateral narrowing. It is unlike rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid mein there is a symmetrical reduction. Yahan par there is an asymmetrical reduction, where medial reduction is more than the lateral reduction. Now what after this? The next X-ray sign after this is an osteophytes. Don't worry, we'll show you osteophyte. Then after osteophytes, you will have what? Loose bodies. Don't worry, we will show you that as well. Then after loose bodies, you will have subchondral sclerosis. And after subchondral sclerosis, I'm sure you are going to see subchondral cyst formation. Alright, so I will show you these X-ray signs. Abhi dikhata hu main aapko ye X-ray signs dikhata hu. So first X-ray sign is reduction of the joint space. First of all, this is the medial area, this is the lateral area. So you can see the medial reduction is more as compared to the lateral reduction. Now what is this? Just take a look. What is this? This is an osteophyte. Did you see that? This is an osteophyte, a classical osteophyte. Now, are we really concerned about, osteophyte? Are nahi hai. The problem with osteophyte is that probably sooner or later, today or tomorrow, it will break down to make what? Loose body. Now, this excessive whitishness that you see, it is what is called as subchondral sclerosis. Had it been rheumatoid arthritis, you would have seen subchondral erosions, you would have seen subchondral lysis. Here you have subchondral sclerosis. And if you see this area, if you see this area, the synovial fluid has accumulated in this area, and that is why this area is what is called as an area of subchondral cyst formation, because we all know that, you know, fluid collection is called a cyst. So are these x-ray signs clear to all of you? So you have reduction in the joint space, that to an asymmetrical reduction, followed by osteophyte, followed by loose body, followed by sclerosis, followed by subchondral cyst formation. Alright, now when we come to the next component of it, we talk about management. And now since we talk about management, I want all of you to keep your ears and eyes open, because you know this is something which has to do with, you know, your life, because you know there are people around you, their parents, their grandparents, their neighbors. So first of all, let's talk about conservative treatment. My first line of conservative treatment is always non-steroidal anti-inflammatories. Abhi isme main aapko bolta hun that no point in giving diclofenac, aciclofenac, mefenamic acid, ibuprofen. Bilkul nahi. The safest anti-inflammatory is always acetaminophen. I'm sure you guys are aware of it. That is paracetamol. It has been an MCQ. Okay. Now acetaminophen is safest for sure, but acetaminophen has a problem. Like, I'll tell you what is the problem with acetaminophen, that it is not that strong an analgesic. Okay. So here I give you one more option, that is you can give etoricoxib. Okay, you can give etoricoxib. Now guys, I want you to understand the majority of the questions that are being framed these days, whether it is your INI that happened, INI CT that happened, or you know, we are expecting in the NEET PG also, it happened last year also. Majority of the questions, they are either clinical or they are derived from a clinical setting. And I have always been very fond of, you know, teaching in a clinical pattern. You guys know that, you know, OPD next patient please. So I've been doing that for almost now 5 years. So the point that I want you to understand, that this is a practical solution. This acetaminophen is a theoretical solution. The second, and it has been an MCQ. After the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug, the second thing is basically the orthosis. When I say orthosis, orthosis can be simplified in the form of a word called a support. Aap log bahut technical ho jate. So orthosis is nothing but it's a support. And in that, I would want you to know that hinged knee braces are really good. These are unloading devices. They unload your knee. They, you know, put less weight on your knee and they bear the weight on their own. So that is why this is a unloading device. Then we have the visco supplementation. Now when I say visco supplementation, that is nothing but intra-articular injections. These are intra-articular injections, but that is not important. What is important is that these are intra-articular injections of what? Tell me, these are intra-articular injections of what? Kya cheez hai jiska injection lagta? Hyaluronic acid. So, because hyaluronic acid is responsible for increasing the viscosity. So, you want more viscosity. So, therefore, we give intra-articular injection of hyaluronic acid. They are marketed by different names. You know, Hyal-1, Hyalgan, Sinvis-1, many names. Apart from this, the next thing that I would suggest here is that we use again often is, there are certain salts in medicine like diacerin, like chondroitin sulfate. Ye naam important hai aapke liye. Okay, like S-adenosylmethionine. You know, there are different salts. I mean, I will tell you that articular cartilage has got no regenerative capacity on its own. But it is believed that there are certain salts, if you give them in the form of a medicine, they can heal the articular cartilage, although it will always remain as a, you know, controversial point of view. So diacinan is one, chondroitin sulfate is one, acetonisilmethanin is in one, and now the previous AIIMS question, glucosamine, ye aapne zarur suna hoga. This was 2017 AIIMS exam question. So, you know, I've been telling you that is tarah ki bhi questions aate hain. These kind of questions are also being asked, so you should be aware of them. Alright, so we have the painkillers, we have the orthotics, we have the viscous supplementation, we have certain miscellaneous salts. But let me tell you the thing which really prevents this disease is isometric quadriceps strengthening exercises. I mean, if you are good in late 40s, if a elderly female is doing all these exercises, so I mean that gives fantastic results. So these are the core crux of the conservative measure. As well as the surgical measure is concerned, we do a surgery called as high tibial osteotomy. It is not done for each and every case. It is done basically for people who are less than 60 years of age, who have a unicompartmental osteoarthritis. There is no inflammatory or crystal induced component. Alright. So, and it is basically the surgery for deformity correction. It is a surgery mainly for deformity correction. Do not expect a magic that everything will be, you know, perfect. The next thing is that we can perform arthroscopy. Now, how arthroscopy can help? It removes the debris, it removes the loose body. Okay, it can, this is a very, very important benefit of arthroscopy. And there is something that you can do is autologous chondrocyte implantation. You can actually autologous chondrocyte implantation. Don't worry, I'll show it to you. So this is a loose body. It was removed. Now this is a patch of articular cartilage defect. So healthy cartilage cells were taken. They were grown in vitro and they were put into that patch and the patch got filled. So there are multiple advantages of arthroscopy, but gold standard treatment was, is and will always remain the same. I'm sure you guys have heard of it, you guys have used this term many a times. That is what is called as a TKR. Alright, so that is what is called as a TKR. Now this is totally replacement, and the only absolute indication of doing a TKR is pain. The only absolute indication of doing a TKR is pain. Alright, so this is the summary of the medical, the conservative as well as the surgical treatment for osteoarthritis. Now if you see, guys, if you see, we have gathered, you know, many MCQs. Not only we have gathered the MCQs about the joints, we have gathered MCQs about the staging, we have gathered MCQs about the deformities, we have gathered MCQs about the X-ray features. Then in treatment, glucosamine has been a question, indication for TKR is pain has been a question, hyaluronic acid has been a question, safest anti-inflammatory has been a question, high tibial osteotomy is not suited for which people has been a question. And not only this, I will give you some more MCQ. See, it is by now it is clear that in osteoarthritis most common joint in world is knee. Now what my question is that in osteoarthritis of knee, which is the most common compartment which is involved? The most common compartment is medial. The most common bone is patella. It's not femur, it is not tibia, it is patella. The most common muscle is vastus. It is not quadriceps femoris. Everybody knows it is quadriceps femoris. But which part of quadriceps femoris? Vastus medialis. Arey Baba, which part of vastus medialis? Vastus medialis obliquus. So again, this has been, you know, these questions have been asked as well. asked as well. All right. So, I wanted to cover, I wanted to take a demo, but in that demo, I wanted to cover a topic in as much as brief I can. But I wanted you to understand that, MCQs are something which are derived from theory, but they are important because they are helpful when you apply them clinically. Rote learning has definitely got no role in today's scenario. You have to have a theoretical setup, you have to have a theoretical background. But when you try to apply that thing into the clinical form, then only you will be able to solve MCQs. And since the concept, which has been asked these days, usme cheeze bilkul clear hai, that if you don't apply a clinical logic or if you don't take any theoretical topic on a clinical tangent, you're not justifying to the entire task. आप अगर एक टॉपिक को क्लिनिकल टेंजेंट पर लेके नहीं जा रहे हो आप इसका मतलब यू जस्ट वेस्टिंग टाइम आई वुड से डोंट यू नो आई डोंट वांट टू साउंड हार्श बट यू जस्ट वेस्टिंग टाइम सो एवरी टाइम यू रीड एनीथिंग ट्राई टू डिराइव अ क्लिनिकल नॉलेज आउट ऑफ इट बिकॉज दैट इज द थिंग विच इज गोइंग टू प्रॉब्ली यू नो बी इन योर हेड फॉर अ लॉन्गर टाइम एंड दैट विल हेल्प यू टू डेवलप अ स्पाइनल रिफ्लेक्स व्हाइल यू विल बी सॉल्विंग एमसीक्यू. Okay, so I am seeing the chat box, but there's one query that I can see. Somebody has asked me, Dr. Hakim has asked me, contraindication of high tibial osteotomy. See, it's very simple. Contraindication of high tibial osteotomy, the first contraindication is inflammatory arthritis. Is sabse pehli contraindication hai. So, if you have a patient of rheumatoid arthritis, don't do a HTO. Then, if you have a crystal-induced arthritis, let us say if a patient of gout is there, you are not supposed to do that. If the amount of correction required is more than 15 degree, then we don't do it. If there is a pre-operative flexion deformity of the knee of more than 15 degree, we don't do it. If the pre-operative knee flexion is less than 90 degree, we don't do it. Bi or tri-compartmental disease. Tricompartmental osteoarthritis, we don't do it. So these are the basic ones that I've mentioned. Okay, if there is a medial tibial bone loss, of more than 3 millimeter, we don't do it. Lateral joint subluxation more than 1 centimeter, we don't do it. ठीक है डॉक्टर हाकिम. ओके सुष्मिता साहा, थैंक यू सो मच सुष्मिता. आई रियली होप यू नो दैट यू ऑल्सो एंजॉय ऑर्थोपेडिक्स एंड यू अप्रिशिएट ऑर्थोपेडिक्स एज मच एज आई डू. मेरी तो जिंदगी है और कुछ बचा नहीं है इसके अलावा. Dr. Muhammad Suhail, sir, for the 12-month subscription, will it be till next December or till the next 2022 exam, as we don't know? Yes, Dr. Suhail, don't worry. Extensions are always there, considering the unpredictability that we have these days. So, as and when, the exam will happen, all subscriptions, whether of this year or the next year also, they will be till a particular date, oblique the NEET PG exam, whichever occurs earlier. Okay, if you still have any query, I am giving you my WhatsApp number also. You can WhatsApp me also. I will try to, sort the issue on personal basis also. Dr. Hakim, there is no reason about it. It has been an observation. Soumya, you have asked me a very good question about proximal fibular osteotomy. Soumya, there is still not enough literature available. Soumya, meri baat bahut dhyan se sunna. तुमने एक बहुत अच्छा क्वेश्चन पूछा है. आई हैव सीन मेनी पीपल डूइंग इट. आई नो मेनी असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर्स इन डिफरेंट मेडिकल कॉलेजेस ऑफ द कंट्री. दे आर डूइंग पीएफओ इन ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिस. देर आर सर्टेन पीपल हु आर प्रो पीएफओ. आई एम नॉट प्रो, आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट, बट द ओनली थिंग इज दैट आई स्टिल फील दैट द सब्सटेंशियल लिटरेचर इज स्टिल नॉट अवेलेबल. ठीक है, वो ठीक है, जो लोग बोलते हैं कि नहीं ये आर्टिकल आया वो आर्टिकल आया, मैंने नहीं देखे. आई हैव सीन जस्ट 5-6 आर्टिकल्स. आई वांट अ सब्सटेंशियल डेटा ऑन प्रॉक्सिमल फिबुलर ऑस्टियोटॉमी बिफोर आई एक्चुअली स्टार्ट दैट डूइंग. सौरव, रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ डेली फेस टू फेस विल ऑलवेज रिमेन फेस टू फेस. देर आर डेफिनेटली एडवांटेजेस ऑफ फेस टू फेस. यू नो, यू एंगेज मोर, यू kind of there is more involvement. Your cerebral cortex is more stimulated in face to face as compared to any other satellite or app based medium. This is something that, you know, at least I have learned in the lockdown, because I feel now that in the last 9 months, you know, a lot of teaching has happened, but not probably that, you know, in that proportion, not that learning has happened. Because ho jata hai, at one point of time, you know, your mind gets clogged, so there is no doubt about it. Yes, face-to-face students will get an app also. Abhishek, next year, all the students who are enrolling with us, if they are attending face-to-face, they will have an app access as well. Face-to-face mein app will be a component of that face-to-face lecture for sure. There is no doubt about it. Any other query that you guys want to ask? Shilpa Seni, thank you so much. I'm absolutely fine, doing well. Saurabh, no need to join face to face if I join app class. Yes, absolutely Saurabh. There is no need to join face to face if you join the app based class. I mean, it all depends upon your need and your wish. I personally feel that there should be one motto in life, that, you know, they say that whenever there is a will, there is a way. So if you have the will, we have the way. So if you have the will ki nahi mujhe padhna, I want to study, so we have the way. We will give you options. There is a face-to-face with app, there is a satellite with app, and there is an app. So if you feel that your XYZ reason is there not to go for face-to-face, you can have the similar effect and the similar things on an app-based medium also. Thank you, Sitakshi. Thank you so much. Thank you, Nupur. Thank you, Abhishek. Thank you, SS. Thank you, Dr. Hakim. Thank you so much. Thank you, Amrita. All right. So I think that should be all for the day. So if at all you have any query, you can reach out to me on Instagram. I'm the most responsive there, followed by Facebook. Now I have given you my personal WhatsApp number also. And if anybody wants to join the app-based live lecture, there is a coupon code which is here, so you can use that and avail some discounts. So thank you so much. Thank you, Parth. It's been wonderful to see you here. You've been a lovely student. I remember, you know, I met you in, I think, Chandigarh, if I correctly remember. And thank you so much, Jyoti. Thank you so much, guys. All right. So have fun, enjoy, and I wish you all the best. God bless you all. Try to make use of every single moment that you have. Do not waste time at all. Keep your focus, keep your head high, and work hard to prove your dreams come true for yourself. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.